everybody. Welcome to another episode of Exploring Photography. I'm Mark Wallace right here in Guaymas, Mexico. It is a beautiful little city, and you can tell behind me we have this pier and a beautiful, the Sea of Cortez right back there, and it is just wonderful. Now, one of the things that people ask me all the time, what lens should I buy? What lens should I use when I'm shooting scenics or portraits or whatever? Well, I think a better way to approach that, instead of asking what lens you should use, is what story do you want to tell? And then based on the story, you can choose the lens. Now, to understand that better, we're going to do something really fun right here in this scene. And that is, the first thing we're going to do is we're going to look at the scene. We're going to look and see exactly what the elements of the story are. Now, once we know what those elements are, then we're going to choose a lens that's appropriate to tell the story of that element. So to make this all make sense, let's first look at the elements of the story. To begin with, we have this beautiful jetty that comes out here, this little dock that comes out into the ocean, and it is wonderful. We have on that dock here, we've got some benches that are sort of weathered, and next to those, we have these rails that have been painted over and over again, and they've really weathered, and so they've got lots and lots of character. Now, out to sea here, we have the beautiful blue water. And then way out to sea, we've got this gigantic rock, this island that's just sitting out here. And then also in this port, we've got these rugged hills, these mountains that sort of border the water. And so we've got the jetty, we've got the mountains, we've got the sea, we've got the benches, we've got the rails. And because this is in a hotel setting up here behind the camera, we actually have some cactus and some shrubbery and things that we can also throw into the scene if we want. And of course, this is a hotel, so there are people that are going to be coming in and out of the scene, so we can use those as elements as well. All right, now that we know about the different elements in our story, let's talk about the lenses that we can use. Now, I've brought with me several lenses, a 21 millimeter wide angle lens, a 35, a 50 millimeter, and 135 millimeter. Now, my wide angle lenses, the 21 millimeter, the 35 millimeter, I'm going to be using those to put things in context. So maybe a bench in the context of the ocean, or maybe a rail in context of the bench, etc. So wide angle lenses, you always want foreground interest to put things in context of a place to tell that story. Now, as your lenses get longer, you're now isolating individual elements of your story, and you may or may not want to put them in context. So you could have a rail that's all by itself with no context around it. You don't know where it is or what its place is. You just know that the colors are pleasing. Or you might be able to use it to get to something that's far away, like that rock way behind me back there. You might want to bring that in a little bit closer using a long lens, but you still have to choose how much of the sea you want to show or how much of the sky you want to show. The story is up to you. So let's do that. I'm going to shoot some of these pictures, and then I'll show you my results with different lenses, and then we'll come back and I'll give you a challenge you can do at home. Well, now that you've seen the pictures that I shot and the different lenses I used to shoot those pictures, the challenge is for you to do the same thing where you live. Find a scene Once you find that scene, explore that scene before you do anything with your camera. Go and look for those elements in the scene that make up a story. The different things that are popping out to you, the color, the texture, the shape, the different individuals, maybe the people in that scene. And then choose a lens that's appropriate for that subject to tell the proper story. Use your wide lenses to put things in context. Use longer lenses to isolate things and put them out of context. Well, I hope this helps you understand which lens to use when, and it helped to improve your photography. If you want to learn more about photography, don't forget to check out the Adorama Learning Center. We have hundreds of videos about photography and shooting video and even recording audio, and it's absolutely free. It's an entire school absolutely free. And also, don't forget to subscribe to Adorama TV. It's also free, and that way you don't miss a single episode. Thanks for joining me, and I'll see you again next time.